I do what I want to. I be with some steppers, I don't care about what you gon' do. What shit like the Warriors, all my niggas gon' shoot. He gon' have to take a loss, so my niggas gon' too. I know a bad bitch and I'm who she belong to. I just picked a Cuban up from Wifey, bitch, these stones new. Dolce and Gabbana's on my feet and he's my favorite pal. Got a lot to lose, still can't be scared to take it down. I was in them slums, shit get dreadful like some Haitian hell. I come from that zoo, it's just cobras, pigs, and nature now. 1300 block a bitch, I call my last cases down. Ain't no second chances in this shit, so we can't play it foul.
Yo, what's up? It's Jack, and welcome back to JackHasWifi. I still need to figure out like some sort of concrete intro because I don't really have like a consistent one. Let me just start off by saying Cloudwheel. If you're subscribed to this channel, chances are you already know what Cloudwheel is. Cloudwheel is a really popular wheel brand amongst the e-skate community. They make like, I want to call them like hybrid wheels. It's like a hybrid of street wheels and all-terrain wheels. They're like really soft, bulky street wheels, but they're also sort of kind of all-terrain wheels. They're not like full pneumatics, but they're like close enough to make your rides like smooth. And Cloudwheel is like been pretty much ruling the game as like probably one of the most popular wheel choices for e-skate. And they expanded out by making their wheels hub compatible. And recently they expanded out even more by making full-on pneumatic wheels. They're actually airless pneumatic wheels, which I think is a term which contradicts itself, because I think pneumatic means aired up and airless pneumatics just means aired up airless wheels. It's a contradictive term, but essentially it's pneumatics without the cons of pneumatics. So usually like if you have pneumatics, it's amazing because the rides are crazy smooth. It's like you have pretty much car wheels, but you do have to worry about your wheels possibly puncturing, running over nails, running over glass, getting flats, normal things like that. But airless pneumatics means you don't have to worry about the cons that usually come with having aired up wheels. So no punctures, no flats, no having to worry about running over glass and stuff like that. Now there might be other cons that come with it. Now I don't quote me on this because I don't know for sure. I haven't actually tested in depth myself, but I have heard that it could affect your range and stuff like that. In my ride session so far, I haven't noticed any sort of like big impact to my range. So maybe it's true, but I don't think it's big enough to really notice a huge difference. Unless you ride to like a very specific location or destination in which you barely make it, then maybe you'll notice a difference. But I haven't really noticed any sort of significant impact to my range at all. So although I'm sure there's probably no lies in that con or saying, it hasn't really been enough for me to really notice it. So I will start off by saying I've done all my testing and all my riding on my Atlas, and it's been amazing, literally amazing. Jumping into the first category, as always, we're gonna start off with design. So these wheels are available in two variants. We have Scarlet Red and Nardo Gray. I believe I said that right. I saw a lot of people go with red. I mean, red does look amazing, but because a lot of people went with red, I went with gray because I wanted to show off something that hasn't been shown off a lot already. So I got gray. And I think gray looks just as amazing as the red. It doesn't stand out as much, but it looks great. I love them both. I wish there was a purple option available. If there was purple, I would have went purple all the way. These are pretty much just like huge cloud wheels with like a layer of rubber. So I guess I can see how that can impact your range because it's like a lot more weight. It's not like an aired up tire, but they do look amazing. I have pictures of like my old stock Atlas wheels compared to these ones, and they make my old ones just look so inferior. It's actually insane. They are a little bigger than my older wheels because these are 165. I think my stock Atlas wheels were 160. But design wise, they are literally beautiful. They look amazing and I love them. Going into the technical spec side of things, they are 165 millimeters and they're available in like the normal wheels that you put on belt drive boards. And they are also available in hubs. So you can put these on many types of hub boards, which is actually something I didn't expect. I don't think there's many boards out there that have pneumatic hubs or hub Pneumatics. So that's actually great that Cloudwheel is like really expanding out their support. They weren't too complicated to install. I watched a tutorial on how to install it, and I will say my Atlas has belt guards, or like the belt covers, and I believe the tutorial said that I had to remove the belt covers or the belt guards. I actually just left my belt guards on and installed the wheels anyways, and I haven't had any issues riding with my wheels and the belt covers. So if you have belt covers and you're worried about like having to have to remove them, I haven't removed them and I haven't had any issues. I mean, if you run into issues, don't blame me. I'm taking a risk right now. I'm just saying it works, and if you want to take a risk with me, you are taking a risk. Because like, it does seem like all the instructions does say to remove the belt covers, I believe. But I left my belt covers on and I haven't had any issues. There's no like rubbing or anything that I've noticed, but it's probably like a really tight fit. Not going into like the convenience and usage, these compared to like the stock Atlas wheels, that's the only frame of reference I have because they are the only pneumatics I've used before this. They definitely feel higher off the ground, which I mean makes sense. They are a little bigger, but it didn't really affect the ride at all. Like it didn't make me feel like I lost balance or anything like that. My balance is still perfectly fine. The ride is actually really smooth. I actually love them a lot. And I imagine their hub variants should feel like pretty much about the same. Then there's like the whole point of these wheels where you don't have to worry about punctures or flats or anything like that. Obviously, they are gonna make your board a little heavier because they're not filled with air. They are like full on like, I don't know the material, but they're like whole wheels, like entire cloud wheels with like a layer of rubber. So your board is a little heavier. It's nothing crazy, but it's a little heavier. And the Atlas is already a pretty heavy board. But with the fact that I was able to keep my belt covers on, and now with the fact that I never have to worry about flats or punctures, it just gave me like so much more peace of mind and like ease of life when it comes to riding, because I don't have to worry about anything getting in my belts. I don't have to worry about my wheels going flat. It's just peace. I have a friend who also has an Atlas, and he also has a set of these wheels now. He used to have the stock pneumatics that came with the Atlas, but he had to completely ditch them because he had so many issues with his wheels constantly going flat. I don't know if there was like a hole or what was wrong with them, but every single time we'd have a riding session, we would have to stop at a gas station like two or three times so we could like refill up his tires with air. It was really bad. So he eventually just, I think he threw them away and just went with like normal cloud wheels. But now he has pneumatic cloud wheels. So he's able to come back to the pneumatic lifestyle because of these wheels. So now running to the end of the video, we are reaching the price and conclusion. So depending on like what board you're buying wheels for, and if you're getting hubs or if like what kind of set you're getting, these might run you like between $250 to $300. I know it's kind of expensive, but I will say from my experience so far, these wheels are definitely worth it. Cloudwheel actually ended up sending me a set of these wheels for free, and I would like to say personally thank you for that. But like around the same time that they ended up sending me these wheels, I did also purchase my own set. So that is why me and my friend Max both have these Cloudwheels, is because they sent me a free set and because I also bought a set. So I'm not talking to you just as someone who's reviewing some free product they got, but I literally spent the full price of the wheels and bought them myself. We ended up putting the free ones I got on my friend Max's board. And so like as an actual customer who spent the money, I can definitely tell you that so far, it has definitely been worth it. I don't think the rubber is gonna wear down that quickly. That was one of my initial worries, was like, oh no, that rubber is gonna wear down quick. But I don't think it actually will. And even after that rubber wears down, maybe the wheel will still be usable as like a normal cloud wheel. Don't quote me on that because I'm not gonna know for sure until we reach that point. I'll definitely make an update video if I ever reach that point. Maybe like after a certain amount of miles or something, I'll do with like some kind of like, I don't know, 500 mile Cloudwheel Rover update video or something. But they are full on all-terrain pneumatic wheels without the cons, or I guess you could say the typical cons of pneumatic wheels. It's given me a lot more peace of mind and has overall just been a great experience. It's kind of weird now because whenever I reach the end of a video on a product and I realize like I haven't really covered any cons, I feel like I need to cover cons, but genuinely, I didn't really have any noteworthy cons. I mean, maybe I should definitely do some sort of range test. I could do a range test with the Cloudwheels, and then I could go back to some stock pneumatics and compare the range of aired up pneumatics to Cloudwheel pneumatics and see if the range is actually significantly impacted. And then also we'll just have to see like how long that layer of rubber actually lasts. I haven't seen anyone like truly like wear it down yet, so I'm pretty sure like it'll last a really long time, but we just can't really know until we reach that point, I guess. If you have anything you'd like to add, any cons, pros, or just any experiences about the wheels, do be sure to let me know down in the comments. And if you're looking into possibly purchasing these wheels for yourself or anything, read the comments and see what other people have to say. But I guess with all that said, that's pretty much all I have to say. I really love to see like all these new innovations that companies are coming out with in the e-skate scene. And just seeing new products like these and like all the new things Nobleman Tech has been coming out with, it's just been nothing but hype and I love it all. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and end off the video there. It's been your boy Jack and I'll catch y'all later. Peace out.